We've got former New York Republican Congresswoman Nan Hayworth, Democratic strategist Michael Starr Hopkins, and After the Bell co-host David Asman. So, David, begin with you. There's a lot we don't know in the healthcare thing, and I do want to get into that in a second, but this is sort of the president's way of saying clear the decks for tax cuts, get a vote going this year. But if it's that late in the year, isn't it also ruling out a tax cut that would be retroactive?
Not necessarily. No, I think you could do retroactive. But the point is that the Republicans lining up against significant tax cuts is very significant. Lobbyists are all swarming over Washington right now. Nan and I were talking in the green room. She knows the lobby situation very well, a former congresswoman. But they are. Congressman Meadows was on our air yesterday saying that just in the morning yesterday, he had four groups of lobbyists to come in to save their particular cut of the pie. Right. Their own deductions that the Trump administration wants to get rid of. And then you have people like Senator Corker. Now, he's been known for getting in the way of a lot of things Trump wants to do, but now it's taxes. He said to NPR, unless the tax plan reduces deficits and doesn't add to the deficits with reasonable and responsible growth models, and unless we can make it permanent, I don't have any interest in it. Now, the arrogance, who cares what he has interest in?
He's been saying that for some time. Nobody had a dollar to the deficit.
But, you know, Americans just want tax cuts, even if it's not a whole comprehensive plan. They just want to pay less in taxes.
If you had to sort of gauge where this is going, how does it look?
Well, Neil, what Senator Corker said, it tends to be code speak for, I want to raise taxes on someone in the midst of all this, sadly, because that's the kind of language
that... And I want to keep giving deductions
Senator Schumer tends to do, and I don't want to malign Senator Corker, but I always worry about that because they never...
There are others like him, though, who say he's got to be paid for, or fans of static accounting, whatever
you want to call it. Well, that's just it. That's exactly the word, the opposite I was going to use, exactly, the antonym. Dynamic growth. That's the whole idea of cutting taxes on everyone, broad tax relief, is that we grow the economy and then we actually put more people into the revenue cycle because they are actually productive and paying taxes. But so it's an important
Michael, where do you see
aspect.
That going?
So many of these politicians ran on not exploding the deficit, cutting taxes and not adding to the deficit. And so now they've boxed themselves in because as we
But
try
Michael,
to figure out
can
tax
you
cuts.
See Democrats voting for this? I mean, some of the we know of the three, of course, who are up for re-election next year in states that Donald Trump won appreciably. But beyond, you know, the three, the Heidi Heitkamps or certainly the Manchins of West Virginia, Donnelly in Indiana, can you see
broad
any of them?
Tax reform, no. But I mean, there are small things that I think Democrats would absolutely get on board with. We've talked about this, repatriating funds, reducing business tax to somewhere
around
22%.
But not individual rights.
But no, no. Because the president also wants to tie it to getting
rid of
state and local
taxes. But it is a little weird, though, Democrats lecturing anyone on debt, right?
Right.
It's like me giving you
the world's upside down, right? The six-pack doesn't come.
Some things we can still count.
When I heard that term six-pack, I thought, does it have to be muscle as part of the six-pack?
I like Budweiser.
But, David, let me ask you a little bit about where this goes, because they'll go back and forth on this, and I think they might, as Republicans, try to come up with a fourth rate to satisfy Democrats, but should they?
No. I mean, the point is everybody across the board tax cuts is what has worked every time it's been tried, whether it was by Democrat John F. Kennedy or by Republican Ronald Reagan. The key is these people that focus on the deficits and these deficit hawks, a lot of them are in the bed with the lobbyists inside the Beltway. They don't want those
Absolutely.
Deductions to end. That's one thing, by the way, that I think Michael and I agree on. Corporate welfare is just as bad as any other kind of welfare.
Absolutely.
It creates a sense of dependency. And these people are starting to get the heebie-jeebies. He's worried that they're going to lose their little deduction,
and
whatever it happens to be.
And this is where it all gets hung up on politics, because every state has its, and every congressional district has its particular set of concerns, its particular favorite constituencies.
When you were in Congress, what kind of pressure did the real estate industry
put
on that? Because I would think that
good question.
the real estate industry is
the mortgage deduction,
powerful.
Right? But just the fact that we would double the general deduction so people would have less of a reason to use the mortgage. They're all out of joint on that.
Let me tell you why the real estate industry is so powerful, because realtors are neighborhood people. Mm-hmm. And realtors, at least in the state of New York, everybody's, doing their bit.
But they're actually going to lose business because people might opt for the double deduction rather than itemize?
I don't even think it's that, Neil. Honestly, it's that the price of homes will fall.
So this might
if you can't, and that
this might be stuck by realtors.
Commissions fall. I know you're
realtors are tied to so much. I mean, think about it. Labor, right. Trade.
Sure, but realtors also, they talk with voters because they are the folks out in the neighborhoods. And when their commissions fall, they tend to be unhappy. They can make an argument a politically powerful argument for the mortgage interest tax deduction, which sadly and realistically actually effectively raises the cost of homes and advantages
who
could afford the deduction.
There's one thing that nobody can defend, and I think Michael and I would join forces on this. The NFL, there was a little known tweak to the IRS back in 2004 to allow the NFL owners, who are all billionaires, they're all literally billionaires, to get a deduction. They can deduct 5% of the overall cost every year. That leads to a savings of about $50 million a year to a lot of these places. Yeah. But every year, and why do they have this? Why do billionaires need an incentive to buy an NFL
team? Tax exemption.
Wait a minute,
baseball has a what?
Major League Baseball also has a tax exemption. It's one of the things that, as the president's gone after the NFL and its owners.
So you're not against getting rid of that, are you?
No, I'm not.
So you're Trumpian and wanting to get rid of the deductions?
I think these deductions are absolutely.
That's where populism comes in. That's where positive populism comes in, because these owners are very wealthy people, just as you said, David. And what do? They spread around their political
largesse. This is just one.
Let me ask you this.
And they argue, it's good for the economy.
But let's say they get this voted on. And Michael, I ask you the first. Christmas Eve or whatever the vote is done. I can't see that being retroactive that late. I could be wrong. But how do you think this will all go down if it's a tax cut that takes place next year, not this year?
I think there's going to be a lot of Republicans that are going to get coal in their stockings. I mean, people, Republican voters expected tax cuts. It's baked into some of the... Republican voters aren't going to see it that way because they won't feel it in their taxes.
They'll look forward to a tax cut. What do you think, Dave?
I think anybody that gets money back, and the way that the president is setting this up, particularly to stop with the truckers last night, was brilliant. I mean, you know, there are a lot of small businesses out there, whether they're truckers or anybody else. He claims they're 30 million. That number may be a little wrong, but the point is there are millions of people out there that are going to get deductions.
Truckers aren't getting the estate tax. Like, they're not going to feel the benefits of cutting the estate.
It's the pass-through. It's the fact that instead of paying 40% tax rate for individual, they'll be paying 25%. That's a huge 40% tax cut.
But are you of opinion? I mean, you're Mr. Markets, right? I mean, the markets have been banking on this. I don't think it's exclusively this. Do you think, though, if it is something that happens next year, it certainly beats it not happening any year?
Yeah, the key is, though, how soon does it kick into the economy? How soon does it show effects on the growth?
If it doesn't show, 18-month to 2-year lag, right?
Yeah, but the political component is what I'm getting at. That will the economy show growth from tax cuts before the next election? If not, Republicans might lose.
Spend money that's coming their way.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You think they will here?
Yeah, I think they very well could. I think it's a tremendous psychological
effect.
You
kind of needed Michael was pre-spending.
See my credit card.
I'd like to see you be able to spend plenty more because you'll get tax relief.
See?
But, you know, the markets have risen. People's perception of prosperity has risen precisely because they expect President Trump will lift those
burdens. Do you know where he got that $4,000 figure?
I think it was from calculations that came from his economic counsel.
Really? Okay.